We are all coffee lovers and we so much love these beautiful flavors that we get out of a cup of coffee. The question then is, how can we amplify this taste even more and have an even more beautiful cup of coffee? And this is why we're going to have a look at the tool, which is going to do exactly that. And this is the Nucleus Paragon tool. When brewing and drinking a cup of coffee, the experience that we get out of it, the sensory experience, is made of the tastes that we get on our tongue, but also the flavors that we have in our nose and the aromas that we have in our nose. This is actually set together by a big variety of organic compounds, and many of them are volatile organic compounds, which we smell beautifully when we brew our coffee. So you know when you're brewing your coffee, you have a really beautiful aroma in your nose. The problem is that a lot of these organic volatile compounds are then evaporated in the air and are kind of lost. So the question is, how can we actually manage that we bring these compounds into our cup of coffee so that we have then this experience later when we are drinking our coffee? And this is a question where the Zurich University of Applied Sciences have been working on intensely, and especially when it comes to temperature, they have been researching how they can manage to capture these organic volatile compounds. And they found out that actually, if you're brewing your coffee over something cold, so if you're cooling down your coffee immediately after the brew, you have the chance to capture much more of these compounds. So the bad thing is you have a bit less smell when you're brewing the coffee, but the beauty is that when you're then later drinking your coffee, you have a much, much nicer experience. And then when Sasa, Sestic and the team of Nucleus Coffee Tools have heard about this research that the university has been done, they contacted them and they together were looking for a solution on how they can develop a tool which is then exactly doing this. So capturing the volatile compounds by extracting the coffee over something that is cold or chilled. And what they came up with is this rock, which is ice cold, and you're brewing the coffee over this rock for a really short amount of time. And this is then constructed in this Paragon tool, which is made of three parts. One is then the stand where you have the rock. One is the part where you put your filter on it. And the last one is a dripper where the extracted coffee is being caught when it's then in the dripper still. So what they then developed together is the Paragon coffee tool by Nucleus, where we have this rock here, this golden rock, where the coffee is brewed over so that the compounds are being really kept into the cup of coffee. And the result for you, if you're using this tool, is that you have much more flavorful cups of coffee. It actually amplifies the whole flavors that you get out of a brew, and then you can play around with it, find where and in which part of the brew you get actually the nice flavors out of it. The Nucleus Coffee Tools team itself recommends you that you're using the tool in the first about 20 to 30 seconds of the brew, because from experience, this is where you get the most beautiful fruity floral notes out of it. But give it a try, do it yourself. You have actually everything open to play around with. And when you play around with it, you will realize that it's really a strong difference in flavors that you get out of your cup. And this is why the tool has also been used a lot in coffee competitions, for example. So a lot of people on National Brewers Cup, but even also on World Brewers Cup, have been using successfully this tool. But in addition to that, also home brewers or baristas or just people that really like to bring out more flavors. It's particularly interesting if you're doing light roast and then these floral, fruity brews where you then really are looking for delicate notes that you want to get out of coffee. So much about the theory. Let's now have a look at the tool, how it's constructed and how you're using it. When you receive your Paragon, you will see it has a strong stand, and then here it has three parts. The top one is where you place your filter on it. You can actually use any type of filter brew and then put it directly on the top part. The second one is then where the magic happens, because here is the chilled rock. You actually chilling this in the freezer for at least one day before using it, and then you're putting it into this little part, but then the coffee is dripping down. And the third one is actually a little cup where you then can capture the coffee when it's dripping from your filter. So quite simple. And now I'm going to show you how you brew coffee on the Paragon tool. So here is everything I need for a nice brew of coffee. And the first thing I'm going to do is put my Paragon on top of the scale. And then I take the server and put it also here. And I see that actually the lower part where the coffee is then being captured, the dripping coffee, is about the same height as the rim of this server. Next thing is I'm going to take my frozen rock and I'm going to put the rock on top here. It should be really close to the ring of the server. Next thing is I'm going to take my V60 with the filter paper and I place it directly on top of the rock so that it's really aligned with the rock, so that then the coffee is really dripping all around the rock. And it should be close so that there is a short distance between the paper when it's down and the rock. And then at the end, of course, I take my coffee. And this time it's a semi-anaerobic washed coffee from Peru. Going to put that in my V60. And now I'm ready to brew. And in my case, I will do it like Nucleus recommends. So the first two brews I'm going to put over the Paragon rock. And then the last ones I'm going to do without. So I've poured now 50 grams of water on it for the blooming phase. And then the next brew is 70 grams. And you see how the coffee is dripping over the rock into my server. So I'm putting it now away on top of this little cup, which is then capturing the drips. And I'm going to continue with my next brew, with my next three brews of all 60 grams then. And now when my brew is finished, I can then also put over the V60 on top of the other part, so that everything is then here in this little cup. Nothing is dripping on my table. And that's actually it. Now I've already prepared myself a beautiful cup of coffee. The only question now is, how is it going to taste with or without the Paragon? And that's why I'm going to make another brew with and without the Paragon, and then trying both coffees side by side. Coffees are now ready, and you might have realized it wasn't even me who brewed the coffee, it was Sierra, because she's such a good brewer. But I am now in the honor of tasting these two coffees, and I'm really curious if it's the same or if they taste differently. It's interesting, both are beautiful coffees, but there is quite a remarkable difference between both. So, but I think it's mainly a difference in texture. So this coffee here that was made with the Paragon, it's much smoother than the other one. And also the acidity is much more pleasant in this coffee. So here I have a malic acidity, here I have more of a citrus sparkling acidity, and all in all it a bit more balanced and a bit more pleasant. And what I also think in this coffee is that there is more clarity. So all in all it's a bit a brighter cup. Nevertheless, both coffees are fine, but I think the difference between the one that was brewed with the Paragon in comparison to the other one is quite remarkable and really quite a bit better than the other one. So the winner is the Paragon. I hope this video was helpful for you. If you want to know more about the Paragon or if you want to order one, then head over to our website. You find the link right here, or just if you go to roasterables.com.